Hello, good morning students. Here again Khare sir, and I welcome all of you to this particular video lecture. And this video lecture is about the very very interesting drama. As you know students, we have started the very great drama, and some parts of the drama, for example day first and day second, we have discussed there. In the day first, I taught you what is the meaning of sacrifice, and also the story of Karna and Arjun, and also some brief information regarding Rajput, for example they sing and the Pandit. But students, in the second day I started the drama actual, and in that drama I discussed I characterization of the drama, some characters like Panna, Padma, Banbir, and the relation of the relation between Panna and Uday Singh, and also some important facts regarding Mewat. And what was the condition of Mewat? Because the Mewat was that time, Mewat was kingless. Okay. So as you know, the subject is English, and class 8, class 12. And you all know, you are all familiar. The name of the drama is Great Sacrifice. Yes. The Great Sacrifice we are going to continue in this video lecture, students. And here I am writing the name. The great sacrifice, and page number 54 and 55 we have discussed there. And where we stopped, students? We stopped at last sentence, last line of on page number 55. The line was, the dialogue was of Padma. Okay, Padma. Characters I have written here, like Panna, then Padma, then Balbi, Balbi. Here are some important characters like Uday Singh. Uday Singh, a very important character. And here, son of Panna. Son of Panna. So these are really, really important characters. These are really, really important characters. The Great Sacrifices drama, and the Panna, Padma, and Banbir. These three important characters, they are playing the role. And page number 55, that Padma said, "I haven't yet told you the ghost about Banbir." The ghost about Banbir means very bad thing about Banbir. And in the previous video lecture, I stopped exact at this moment, and I asked you one question, that what would be the ghost thing about Banbir? That the ghost thing about Banbir, today in this lecture we will get the answer of this question. Page number 56, students, page number 56. And now Panna said, what is it? Padma, what is it? And what is it? What is it, Padma? Because the worst thing she wanted to tell, Padma wanted to tell worst thing about Padme, and Panna asked her, what is it, Padma? Tell me. Padma softly said, students, listen. You also listen. The worst thing, listen. Banbir wants to be the permanent Rana of Mewat, and he has resolved to kill the prince.
Yes, students, Padma softly said that Bambi wants to be a permanent Rana. Rana means what?
Rana means king. He wants to be permanent king. He wants to be permanent king.
And how can he be a permanent king? Killing two friends.
Uday Sinha.
Killing to Udaysia, killing to prince, he can be a king. So that's why Padma softly said to Panna, Banbir wants to be the permanent Rana of Mewar and he has resolved to kill the prince. And resolved to means what?
Decide.
He has decided to kill the prince.
Such a cruel person, half brother of little Udaysia.
Killing someone is not good, but in battleship, in war, it's our duty. Okay, it's our duty to kill. But killing a little boy, killing a child, it's not good. How he can kill? How he can kill a little Udaysia? He was infant. He was very little, small, kid, only kid, child, baby boy. He lost his parents, and then his half brother Bambi wants to be a king, and he wants to kill Udaysia. Who told this story? This ghost thing? Padma told this ghost thing to Panna that Bambi wants to be a permanent king of Mewar, and he has decided to kill the prince. And who was the prince?
The prince was Udaysia.
The prince was Udaysia. The prince was Udaysia. After hearing this, Panna said, and I have resolved to save the prince. What a great spirit, what a great thought, what a great thinking, what a great daring. That suddenly Panna said that I have decided to save the king. And I have resolved to save the king. I have decided to save the king.
Bambi has decided to kill the king, but Panna has decided to save the king. These two important characters in the drama, the great sacrifice.
These two important characters in the drama, the great sacrifice. And Panna said, I have resolved to save the prince when the Rani, the prince's mother, was dying.
Yes. Now here, Rani, Prince Mother, when the Rani, Prince Mother was dying,
she said to me,
yes, I told you before also, that Rani, the queen of Mewar, the mother of Udaysia, took promise that Panna will take care of Udaysia.
Panna will protect Udaysia.
That was the promise. That promise was taken by Panna. Who took Princess Mother? When she was dying,
at that time, she said to me, Panna, I have lost everything except my precious child.
Yes.
I have lost everything because she lost her husband, a king, Ramaji. She lost her husband, so that's why she was saying that I have lost lost everything except my precious child, and I am leaving him in your charge. Be a mother to him and protect him from all harm. Be a mother to him. I promised her that I would give my life to save the life of the prince, and she died smiling.
Children, what a great person Panna Ansu, and what the love between the mother and the son, because the mother was dying, and at the time of death, she was thinking about her only child, the precious child who was here, and she was asking, she was taking promise from Panna that be a mother of Udaysingha, be a mother of Udaysingha, and protect him from all harm. And Panna said, yes.
Panna said, yes, I promised her.
Who promised her? Panna promised her. That time, she started smiling. She smiling that.
Why smiling died? Or she died smiling? Because now she was in not tension, she was not in worry, because Panna promised her that she would take care of her child. And the queen of the Mewar, Rani, she died smiling. And Panna also told her that I would give my life to save the life of the prince. So I would give my life to save the life of the prince. That courage of Rajput woman, Panna. So that was Panna also, that is called the epitome of sacrifice. The example of sacrifice, Panna. The really great example of sacrifice, Panna. And then, Banveer cannot kill the prince as long as I or Panna lives. That is the courage. That is the daring. Banveer cannot kill the king as long as Panna lives. As long as Panna lives, Banveer cannot kill the prince. I will fulfill my promise to my late mistress. I will complete my promise. I will fulfill my promise to my late princess, late mistress, the Rani, the queen of the Mewar. And that's why, as long as Panna lives, Banveer cannot kill the prince. It is not possible to kill. It is not possible to kill the prince. Because there was Panna. Though she was a woman, but students, what was the courage? What was the daring? Really great personality, really great Rajput woman was Panna. Panna was. And that's why Panna was telling Panna that Banveer cannot kill the king as long as Panna lives. And I will fulfill my promise to my late mistress. The sound of somebody running outside. Suddenly what happens? They both were talking, and suddenly the sound of somebody running outside. Padma said, listen, there is somebody outside. Who can it be? Oh, listen, there is outside somebody. There is somebody outside. Listen. Who can it be? Panna said, it must be one of the guards. A maid named Champas enters and panting. It must be one of the guards. The next character enters here, Champas. The next character, Champa, fourth character, sorry. The fourth character, Champa, entered entered and Champa, the maid, she was also maid student. Like Parma was the maid, Champa was the maid. And while speaking Parma and Parma, Champa entered in the bedroom. And Champa said, make haste, do what you can to save the life of the prince. Make haste, you haven't any time to lose. But we will be here in the few minutes. Come fast, do something. He is talking to a man outside. He is only 100 yards away from here. Do fast. Ranveer is coming here.
Students, this is the message by Champa. Now what do you do? Now what to do, students? Because Champa told them, do hurry to ask that Banbir
will be here in a few minutes, and the Panna and Padma haven't any time to lose, and do what you can save the life of the prince, because Banbir is coming. The Banbir will be here in a few minutes, and he is talking to man outside. He is only 100 yards away from here.
When he was coming, Banbir was coming to the bedroom of this man, and in the bedroom of this man there was Panna, Padma and Champa, and the son of Panna also. Son of Panna and Udaisi were sleeping. Both were sleeping.
But Champa gave
message that Champa told the both, do what you do to save the life of prince, because Banbir is coming here.
Panna said, how do you know he is coming to kill the prince only?
Panna asked her that how did or how she knew that he was coming to kill the prince only? Because Champa told her that he was coming to kill the prince, and Panna asked her, how do you know that Banbir is coming to kill the prince only?
Some other work will be there, no? Some other work regarding different things. And Banbir, how he can kill this little baby? How do you know he is coming to kill the prince? Champa said, he has a naked sword in his hand.
The sword in his hand.
Bahubali.
With sword in his hand, he will kill the king.
He will kill the king. And a naked sword in his hand. And Panna calmly said, all right,
okay.
The time to do or die has come. Yes, students, now time came to do or die. A time to do or die has come. I must save the life of the prince or die with him.
I must save the life of the prince or die with him, because I promised the Rani that I will save the prince. Now the time to do or die has come,
and I must save the life of the prince or die with him. That is the sacrifice. I must save the life of the prince. Of Ranaj Sam's child quickly lifts the prince from his bed. And students, one very important thing happened.
What a clever and what a sacrifice of Panna. She did something
very horrible. She did something very heart-touching, touchable thing. She did what thing? quickly lifts the prince from his bed.
Here was the bed of prince. Prince was sleeping there. Here was the bed of Champa, and here was the Champa's son was sleeping. Here was the prince. She quickly lifts the prince from the bed, from this bed.
She quickly lifts the prince from his bed and changes his clothes and puts him in a basket.
And she Panna changes his clothes and puts him in a basket. She puts a basket
and then covers him with flowers and leaves.
Flowers. So actual prince was in basket under the flowers and leaves in the basket,
and covers him with flowers and leaves, and said, Panna said, take this basket out of the palace, hide yourselves near the gate, and wait for me there.
Panna told Padma and Champa that take this basket out of the palace.
And hide yourselves near the gate and wait for me, I will be there.
So actual prince was in basket, and the basket, okay, was with Champa and Padma. And Padma told them both maids, take this basket out of the palace and wait for me.
You should also hide. Padma said, lifting the basket said, I will carry him, this most precious basket, under my arm. Champa, follow me.
Padma said, I will carry this most precious basket. Why the most precious basket, students?
Why it was most precious basket? Can you tell me? Yes, it was most precious basket because
in that basket, the actual prince was there, the prince of Mewar was there.
So I will carry this most precious basket under my arm, and Champa,
you follow me.
Champa to Panna said, where are we going to take the prince? No one in Mewar will keep him in his house. So here she asked Champa one question, that where are we going to take the prince?
In Mewar,
there was no person, no one in the Mewar will keep him in his house,
because everyone was afraid of Gandhi.
Where are we going to take this prince or this basket? Panna said, don't worry. I have already thought about it. We will take him to Asashaha, who is good man and friend of ours. I am sure he will protect the prince. Now hurry up and be careful.
And she told her maids that Asashaha, he was the person.
She planned Asashaha. Asashaha was the person, and he was a good man, and he was the friend of Padma and Panna,
and he was an actual real friend of King also. So he will help her. He will protect the prince,
and now hurry up and be careful.
So now students, in the bedroom, there was no prince. The basket also was with Champa and Padma went. Okay, Champa and Padma went.
Now students, the maid goes out taking the infant prince with them, and Panna quickly dresses her own child in the clothes of the prince, really touchable. Only in the bedroom there was a bed of Prince Panna and Panna's own son. She was also little. Panna's own son was there. She dresses up to her son Prince dress, Prince clothes. She dresses up the Prince clothes, puts him in his bed. So she puts him from this bed to this bed. She puts her own son to the prince bed. She looks at him for a minute, kisses him several times and lies down on her bed. The sound of footsteps outside. Banbir enters the room. Hurriedly, Panna gets up from the bed. Banbir says, "Where is the prince?" Banbir asks, "Where is the prince?" "Panna, not so loud, please. He is asleep." "Banbir, he is asleep." Banbir says, Here is he. Panna points to her child with a trembling hand. Panna points herself. There is the king with the trembling hand. Banbir rushes to the bed and kisses the child with his sword. And suddenly Banbir goes to the bed and he kills the child. He kills the child with his sword. Panna shakes and falls down on her baby's body. Banbir looks around and goes out of the room. And after killing the child, Banbir goes out of the room. Panna falls down on her baby's body, because that baby, the child, was killed by Banbir. Panna said in her shocked voice loudly, "Mistress, I have kept my promise to you. I have saved the life of Prince. I have saved the life of Prince." And that was the great sacrifice of Panna's parents. And Panna puts her own son. Panna saves the real Prince Udayasinh, and she lost her own son in front of her. Banbir killed her son, and that was the sacrifice of the Panna students. It is a real history. It's a real fact, students. So that's why this history of Mewar is really important. And students, do you think that type of sacrifice we have to do? Yes, students. Because such a great personality there were. Not only Panna, there were many warriors in the history. They sacrificed their life for the nation only, for the kingdom, for the king, for the India also. Many warriors, many leaders, they sacrificed their life. But this sacrifice is really untouchable. Why touchable? Because small child, own child, was killed in front of her only with a sword. And she saved the real prince. What was the courage, what was the daring of Panna to put her own son on the bed of prince and allow to Banbir to kill her own son in front of her? That is the story of the great sacrifice. Students, it's a heart-touching drama. The real character, the important character in the drama are Panna, Padma also, Banbir, not much, but Banbir also very important character, and Panna also very, very important character. We have discussed here, students, this drama, the great sacrifice. But students, Remaining question answers I will be teaching you in the next video lecture. I will be taking some grammar topics of the drama also. But I suggest you to read this drama at home and complete question answers of the drama and think about sacrificed students, the great sacrifice of Panna, the great sacrifice of Panna. This is Kharade sir. Thank you very much. Bye.